So everybody knows what the kids' tree houses of old, how they were done. 2x4s nailed up against the tree. One of a number of things happened. Either the tree's bark pressure pushed out the nails and the boards came loose, the wind sheared the bolts, or they actually survived. They grew around it, and the treehouse lasts for years and years. Oh, the other thing that a kid's tree, the wood would rot next to the tree. So knowing this, I decided to put metal on the tree. I put a metal bracket, all different kinds of metal brackets I used. Some of my first ones were using channel and putting it up against the tree and bolting it to the tree, all right, with lag bolts. We tested that and that held pretty strong. Out of two 3/4 inch lag bolts, we could get 3,000-4,000 pounds. Because it's up against the tree and it's got the friction, it's holding it there, and then the tree grows around it and get bolster blocks it, which like this, that's not gonna move anywhere. That's not gonna go anywhere, all right? But it's very intrusive to the tree. And on this one here, somebody bolted some wood, some 2x6s and 2x8s right to the tree. What you actually see up there on the top is that the bark of the tree has actually been able to push it away from the tree. It's actually pulling the bolts through the tree. Now those are strong, but they're not very nice to the tree, and then it's going to rot after a while. Those were, say, the second generation. Okay, this is what goes on behind one of these brackets. You can see that it's trying to grow around this, but it stops. The bark can't grow out anymore, and it's trying to capture around it. So this bracket I took off, this is what it did within like 3 or 4 years. All right, now this is a Garnier limb that's been in a tree for a while. Now it's more intrusive in the beginning, but as you can see, as it grows around it, it becomes less intrusive. Another way of look, you can look at this guy's over here. So if you look at those pipes, it's growing right around it, right up to them.
Just like a limb.
The
pipes are over the end of a Garnier.
They're over the end of a Garnier limb.
Okay.
All right. So this is a bracket that was first knee braces. Basically, it started growing around this. Okay. And the thing is, you can take this out. Now, what I can do with that though, is I can put on a piece of pipe. I can take this same piece of pipe and I can put an extension on. All right, so most of my brackets, what I use is I use a piece of pipe with them. Take your bracket off, put a longer extension on it, and move your bracket out. And that's one of the things that you want to look for when you get a bracket and when you design your treehouse. I mean, you can spend more money, have it out away from the tree more, but a lot of times you think, oh, I'm not going to worry about it. This is, you know, I'm only going to use it for 10 years. But in 10 years comes along and you still like it and you want it and everything. So then what I'm saying is, the way I designed a lot of this stuff, you can extend it. But if you have spent a little bit of time and a little bit more money in planning, you can put something that's in there that has more room for growth. So, but if you spend twice as much on your bracket or in your hardware, it'll last twice as long, basically, is what I'm trying to say. The whole thing with the artificial limb or the GL or the tab was to try to simulate a limb to be able to allow for movement and allow for growth. This is a real neat tree house. This is in Washougal, and it's up on the top of a cinder cone. And these are quite dynamic. It's got three different platforms there. This is a double tree, which we'll have some drawings and show you that. This is a regular single tree. And these have stabilizer boxes on them. So this is some bracketry that's more high tech. It's also because of the wind loading on that. That's up on top of a ridge and in like a 100-mile-an-hour zone. And it's like 24 feet up in the air. So one of the dynamics on a two-tree treehouse is that one side is fixed. One set of these joists are fixed and then the other side floats. And basically what we used on these, and if you've got a lot of weight and you've got a lot of tension, you know, and everything, you want to use some, this is a UHMW, high density, ultra high molecular weight plastic, and that will reduce your friction and reduce your load from your wind.
How far are those trees moving in the wind?
Those there, that's a 3 inches, 4 inches, it's up on top of a ridge there, you know. No, but that's a lot of movement. These guys wanted this thing higher and higher, and I said, I don't know, man, you know, and I got them to get down to 20 feet or 22 feet on this, and they're a single tree. They wanted, at first they wanted it 50 feet, you know, and I got them down to 35, and then this first windstorm they were in, they was, I understand what they're saying. Charlie did stabilizing boxes, he did rings. And the thing I don't like about rings is they're kind of limited in your growth. Here I have these corners that are, there's more room for growth. It stabilizes your, all right, when you've got a knee brace, these are, they're held up, not just by a GL, but they have a knee brace on the bottom of them. When you have a knee brace, you're out here, there's a downward force, there's an in force, and then there's an opposite outward force. So if you have this box, it's pulling out this way, but on the other side it's pushing in this way. And in a high wind area, basically I wanted to have something that stabilized all those forces.
Is that box steel?
It's steel, yeah.
Steel box. Okay.
Okay, so that's how it's bolted together here in these corners. And then you can actually take it apart. One of the ways I designed this is, now once this tree grows out over these bosses, all right, it actually encapsulates, this boss would be inside the tree, so then it can't pull out. That's one of the things that, you know, I'm trying to come up with more and more, is how to make the stuff last longer, because damn it, if the trees don't just keep growing, man. You know? When I use an extra boss, a lot of times these are just 4-inch bosses. I'll put 3 inches of it in and only leave an inch of it out. Because I want it to grow into the tree, all right? And in that first year, it's gonna put on reaction wood faster, more. And so it'll use up most of that and then strengthen it. And then I want it to become less intrusive. I actually want it to become enclosed in the tree. I want it to grow inside the tree. Okay, now this is one that we did in Hawaii. This is for the treehouse guys. And it's in a giant monkey pod tree. The trip with these trees here is your branches end up, they go horizontal. A lot of your trees, when you got multiple trees, you got your regular column, okay? And it's easier to design. These ones here really head scratchers in that, okay, you've got this big branch that's hanging out over there, and it's not even supposed to, engineer wise, they can't even, sometimes it doesn't, the numbers don't, if Nabil ran the numbers on it, that thing wouldn't, he couldn't get it past code. The bracket that I basically designed on this, or how I did this, and I guess this is something to discuss. You know, it's up and these things move around. So I've got the horizontal loading.
There wasn't a cable, like instead of doing
the... Well, where would I hang the cable from?
Well, I don't know. That's what I was asking. There wasn't anything
above.
The monkey pods have a lot of branches.
Yeah, but if it's a branch up above, that's going to move around. These things are out there in a windstorm. They're just, you know, moving. So if you got a cabled up there...
Like when the wind hits that tree and the branches, the limbs start bending. This one obviously bends not just vertically, it's in a dimension where it's going up and down. So,
right.
So in theory, this, your treehouse is getting all these weird diagonal stresses.
Exactly. Yes. Yes. This was a real head scratcher, basically. And then finding the spots in the, you know, a good spot on these trees that we could put the treehouse in level. This is a fixed bracket that is for an adjustable knee brace, and it's out further. Like, I would say you could go 2 inches out with a fixed bracket easy, on a structure like this where your inside loading isn't that much, you can go 3 inches out, all right? Because most of your weight's being carried on the outside. And it's gonna get stronger as it grows around it. And it's gonna be stronger because this whole thing now is inside the tree. So it doesn't only have to turn the GL, it has to turn this bracket here and move all kinds of stuff. These are 2-to-1 and they're not as strong as say a 1-to-1.
My question about the knee braces, is the optimal angle like 45 degrees or are there advantages to having longer?
Well, if it's longer, it actually will hold more. I mean, you don't want to go less than 45. Basically, to get a 45, it's really easy. You go down 4 feet. Then if you go out 4 feet, then you go down 4 feet. And that's, then it gives you a 45 degree angle. All right, these are double knee braces, are in the same plane. So they don't really work for a single tree house. Normally they're for, if you've got one tree, you put your beam across. All right, that's what this one here is, okay? That's one that's actually back up in the hills. So you want your tree to be pretty much straight up and down. So you have your fixed bracket here, right? It needs to be fixed. All your knee braces need to be fixed. Then you do this, all right? Now, if you had a sliding bracket up there, and you have knee braces, there's nothing really here to hold it. That thing can actually tip back and forth. You want this point to stabilize the whole thing. So if you've got two trees and one of them leans out from it and the other one's straight up and down, then you would like put a double knee brace on one side and then put single knee braces on the other side. And the side that leans out that you put the single knee braces, that's going to hold more weight. So that would be the side that you would say cantilever your porch out and hold more weight that way. This is one of Jake's brackets. This is another type of knee brace bracket. It's sort of like a double knee, but it's all fixed together. He calls it a nave bracket. You have to usually have these fabricated site specific. For one, I've doubled up I have an adjustable knee brace there for more load bearing. I also, on this one here, I actually put a through bolt through the tree and with a boss on the back side. That's a heavy duty bracket assembly there, but it's custom made for, a heavy duty job. And then it's got the knee braces that come down one on each side. So your load on this, the center one carries half the load and these end two each carry a quarter of it. So the center one actually has two GLs on it, and each of these other ones have one GL on it. And then this will be made the same way with the joist fixed on one side and sliding on the other. Bracketree, and this is bracketree that's, you can do, this is basically held by a cable, but the main bracket that supports it is this thing, this bow part of it that comes down and holds it. And then these other brackets, actually these have got pipes on it coming out from the tree, like these guys here, all right? And then the bracket's on the end of it, and then it's cabled back up to a tree. It's a single tree, it makes it help it look like a ship, and it supports your cantilever out there. These are some other things that we tested. This one here had a bolt in it. Charlie Greenwood came up with this way, which was held in by a lag bolt. Okay, so we tested this. This was Jonathan Fair Oaks. All right. Okay, here's another one of what Charlie's was like. Okay. Of these three, which one do you think held the most? This one here. Yeah. Why? It's big. It's massive. It is 12 inches long. We had to drill this giant hole in there. We had to take a sledgehammer and smash it in there. We only got 10,000 pounds out of this. And we couldn't get any more with my hydraulic jack and stuff. We couldn't figure out why we couldn't get any more until we released it. I had it in one of these trees over here. When we were pumping it, we got to 10,000 pounds, and we couldn't tell. It was just picking the tree up. When we released the jack, we could see it drop. The numbers on this were kind of disappointing, but this here was promising, and basically because we tested this up just up against a regular bolt. So we got just the bolt, 2,500 pounds, you know, before it moved through that. This, we got 6,500 pounds out of it by just adding this boss. I don't say that I invented the GL, I developed it. And why didn't I go this way?
It's just overwhelming, it's too much.
It's too much, right. I was looking for something that could be more easily installed and less expensive to build. This guy here was, you know, it's a massive thing, and it wasn't practical putting it in the tree, and it seemed like a lot of damage. And this one here was, you know, very promising. Anyway, we upped the size here, up this to 3 inch instead of 2.5, and put on better threads. This is the first production line. And then this one here, we got to hold 8,000 pounds. Putting a better thread on it, okay, this is, grabs it more because part of it's pull out from the tree. And then we upped the size, the diameter of this, and then the width of this too. And actually we've then gone to 1 inch. The standard was 1 inch, and then we got the, you know, we have the, you know, the heavy limbs, okay? You know, I've sold, you know, thousands of these. And they seem to work really well. And we've told you where you got to watch out where you is that cyclical loading.
What's the optimal box size, diameter?
Well, 3 inches, and basically, I mean, it's because it's the easiest, you get any bigger and it's harder to take that much out of a tree.
Okay.
Now, these here, these are Charlie's. What are these things rated at?
It varies, but they're averaging out at least 16,000 pounds.
The rated? I mean, we're holding.
Holding.
Holding. So, and that's in a Doug fir? Or?
It's in a Doug fir, yeah. Mm-hmm. They have a nice withdrawal or holding power from withdrawing from being pulled out. It's a little tricky to install with this. You drill initially an 1 3/8 diameter pilot hole and then chase it with this tapered bit. But once the hole is cut, this goes in fairly easily. This is called a flower drive bit, and it's supposed to marry up with this socket, female socket inside, and then this would be the driving mechanism. But then this fits onto 1.5 inch socket, and this is a torque multiplier. Mm-hmm. So you can initially turn it 1-to-1 like this, and then this is a 200-to-1 multiplier, which allows you to get it in quite easily till it's driven home. And then, of course, from this, you can then start attaching any extension to it.
And you could put any of these other brackets to just be bigger and, you know.
So then you drive this in, and then in this particular treehouse case, I'm not going to drive it all the way in because it gets difficult to take apart. Then this fits, a bracket fits over this, which then takes a set of struts.
For most people that do most tree houses, this is very adequate. You know, with stuff that Charlie's working on and some of these other guys, then, you know, they're doing these massive tree houses. And to me, I'm not really into that. I'm into having a tree house that's more balanced with the tree. I'm not into having, I mean, I have a big tree house that I live in, but it's spread out. It's, you know, it's not all on, I don't have these giant point loads. This guy here, you got to get an installer for this, you know. And it's kind of the same thing. It was kind of the same thing with this. This is very strong, but it just wasn't practical. Well, you want to pick a tree that is a good compartmentalizer. That's one of your bases that you want to do for picking out a tree. Some trees are not very good. Our ash trees here are, you know, you cut off a branch and it's a hollow spot, you know, within 5 years or so. That you see them more in some trees where you where a branch is missing and there's a hollow spot in there. All right. Sometimes it's, I mean, trees is inevitable to get them if you have it one that connects moisture, that collects moisture and keeps and doesn't have the moisture, doesn't roll off. But some trees like cottonwoods, I'd stay away from because of that. You know, there's, you know, and fast-growing trees usually aren't that good at compartmentalizers because what they're doing is they're usually the first trees back in an area, like in wet areas, flood areas. They come back and they grow up quickly, and they reproduce quickly, you know. And then they provide nutrients then for the next generation of trees, or you know their purpose is not the same. You want to pick a tree that lives a long time and gets big. I favor the cables. My engineer favors the knee braces. Well, the cables, I think they're more flexible. There's no pullout on your GL from a cable. You can put it closer to the tree. They're easier to install.
There you go. See, the key is here. Well, the cable is just attached to the top of the tree where you move the most. That's why I kind of don't feel good about it. But while the knee brace, as you can see here, it's connected to closer to the ground, so it moves less.
And it's also closer to, the two points are closer together.
Yeah.
The platform and the knee brace. The other one, your platform and then you're up, I'm up 23 feet.
On the cable one, you should keep the cable length as short as possible if you use that.
The higher up you got, the more straight pull down you have.
Right.
If
so
you're down lower, you got to pull right. out on your cable.
Yeah, also they are in your way. You have to go higher because you are in, if
yeah,
you, if you make it shorter, it will be in your way. Going back to the knee brace, to be honest with you, I like it 60 degree too. I disagree with Mike. 60 degree to me, better. Like what you see right now.
I said at least 45. Okay.
Yes.
I said if you make it more, it'll actually support more. It'll be more in shear. It'll be more, there will be less pull out.
No, if you can make it knee brace and cables, that we call redundancy. If one of them failed, the other one would work. That would be the best.
Okay, anything else? Okay, that's it.
All right.
Yeah.